In this short video, I am going to explain to you what is data analysis and how you can use this for your research. And we are starting right after this short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. Recently, two of my subscribers, they requested me to make videos on data analysis. And the problem is that this is a big field and you have to make at least 5 videos in order to explain this subject. But then I decided to help my subscribers, students, whatever I could by explaining a bigger picture of data analysis. And in this video, as you can see, that this is a diagram which I am going to explain to you, and hopefully you will get some idea out of this, what is data analysis and how you can use this in your research. Because some students, when they are starting their PhD, they even don't understand where several things fit together. So in this diagram, which looks a little bit chaotic at this moment, I am trying to explain, without giving any example, how you can use data analysis in your research. Now the first question is, why I am not using any example in this? And the reason I am not using any example is because my main discipline is engineering, but most of my subscribers, they are not engineers. They are from other backgrounds. So if I put any example from my field of research, they might not understand this. And if I use a very simple example, like from social sciences, then that will not be very useful. So therefore, I made this bigger picture as open-ended so that you can apply this to your research. And here is how you can do this. First of all, at the top of this diagram, as you can see, that I have mentioned research objectives and a research question. So your research objectives must be clear to you. And these research objectives can be more than one. 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever are your research objectives. So the first thing you should make clear that your research question is closely associated with your research objectives. So actually your research question emerges from your objective of the research. But your research question should be very specific and very focused. Now, the first thing you need to do is make your research question. And for this, what you can do, there are a lot of videos I have made which will help you to understand how to develop a research proposal or a research question. You can watch those videos in PhD section in a playlist on my channel. But once you have created your research question, then you try to brainstorm and try to think about 3, 4, 5 more questions. And the important thing about these sub-questions, as you can see here, Q1, Q2, Q3, these sub-questions must be those questions which will shed light on your main research question. If you get answers to these sub-questions, then you should be able to shed some light on your main research question. This is very important. And if you don't do this, then all your data analysis will be waste of time. So from your main search question, try to figure out some simple sub-questions which are relatively simple to get answers. This is another condition. Your research question is a complex question, but these sub-questions are the questions which are relatively simpler than the main question. And once you figure out these questions, these questions not necessarily be only 3 questions, there could be 5, 6 questions. Then you determine what are the variables in these questions. What are the things which are changing based on some other parameters in this question? So there could be certain fixed parameters and certain variables. And now, because these sub questions are simpler than your main research questions, so one question could be in which you are trying to find a relationship between 2 parameters. For example, I have shown in this diagram a violet and a yellow. These are the 2 parameters you want to get a relationship between these 2. Then there is another question in which you want to find out a relationship between any other 2 parameters. And then there could be a question where you want to find out a relationship between not 2, but more than 2, 3, 4, 5 parameters. and that question is so complex that you cannot separate the variables. You can only figure out the effect of all those variables together. So think about your problem, and then you will find that most of the questions in PhD research specifically, they fall under this category, in which there are a lot of variables acting together, and you can only get a complete output, but you cannot separate those variables. And I will talk about this in the last part of this video. So now you have these three sub questions. You have a set of variables, just make a list of all those variables and how you are going to collect the information. And now you collect the information from one of the data sources. And on this figure, you will see I have mentioned few data sources, but there are actually unlimited types of data sources available for you. They are not 5 or 10 data sources. Like you can get data from experiments, you can get data from surveys, interviews, focus groups, historical data, but you can also get data from other sources. Once you have got that data, for example, when you are making surveys, you have to create a questionnaire. I have made a video about how to create a questionnaire. That is a detailed video about questionnaire. You can watch that video. I will put that video at the end of this video. So what happens now is that you are getting a lot of data, and some of this data is not useful. Some variables are the variables of interest, but there is some other information which is not very useful. Don't discard this information straight away. You have to find a data processing, a preliminary data analysis, which is called data processing, in which you try to filter out and find some organized data now. Because for example, you are gathering data on your Google spreadsheet by using Google Forms, which is a kind of survey. Now, that Google sheet contains a lot of data. Then you just look at that data, and this is the processing part. Look at that data, just scan or make some quick plots between any two variables, because there will be a lot of variables. And you can understand that this data is not relevant actually. You can discard this, or you can keep it for later referral if you find later on that this is actually a very important data. After this preliminary data analysis, you will get a set of organized variables. So this is your organized data. You might have to manually organize this data. For example, cutting and pasting the variables of interest, put it in columns where you are actually going to do the final analysis. Now, here is the part which is most important. Once you have this organized data, this is the scientific part which begins from here. Once you have the organized data in front of you, for example, if there are only a relationship between two variables which you are interested in, as I shown here, the violet and the yellow, for example, then you might be thinking about plotting a scatter plot, which is a type of data analysis tool. So you might plot a scatter plot between this violet and yellow thing. Then another two variables are there where you might be interested in plotting a histogram, because histogram provides you a certain type of information. Then if the variables are together, complex form, then you might be interested in using some other tools, more sophisticated data analysis tools, which can handle this kind of data. And these tools are, for example, principal component analysis or singular value decomposition or some other linear algebra tools or statistic tools. Now, this is the selection at this point which you have to make, that which tool is appropriate for the data analysis of these particular variables. So this is the final stage. And once you have used any of these methods and you get the appropriate results of these three sub questions, which will shed some light on your main question, then your data analysis is complete. That is it. Now you have to discuss the results. Now you can say that this was our research questions. We investigated these three sub factors which are affecting our main question, and this is the result. This is what we found. And if you want to support an argument, you have to provide the most critical thing, which is called the evidence of your hypothesis, or the evidence or the proof of what you are trying to say, that this is my original contribution to the knowledge, and this is the evidence of this. This is the proof of this. So this is what will make your PhD. This is the core of your PhD. Now the tools and techniques which you are going to use, this is a separate knowledge you have to gain by taking a course in, for example, linear algebra. So there is another video which I have already made, which says that three subjects which every PhD student must take. So please watch that video and you will understand. And there are some other videos also available for PhD students. If you are doing PhD and you are new to my channel, so you may watch those videos. So I hope that this video will help you understand what is data analysis and how you can apply this to your own research. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and see you next time.